Now we'll see theorem 3, which is in page 163 in NCERT. So the statement is like this: if a function f is differentiable at a given point c, we have seen it in previous video, when is a function said to be differentiable? When the left hand limit is equal to the right hand limit is equal to the function value, is equal to the derivative of the function at that point c. So if a function f is differentiable at point c, then it is also continuous at that point. This is what we are supposed to know. So what we are trying to say from here is, if you are stating someone saying that the given function is differentiable at point c, then it is indirectly understood that that function is continuous at that particular point. Okay, so how to prove it? See, this proof will not be asked for the exam, but it is for our understanding. So in the previous video I showed you that limit extends to c f of x minus f of c divided by x minus c. If this is equal to f dash of c, then you can say that the given function is continuous. It is very much similar to what we did in continuity. In continuity, what did we do? We told limit extends to c f of x is equal to f of c, then the function is continuous. Whereas if this kind of a condition is followed for differentiability, then you say that the given function is differentiable. So since they have already mentioned that the given function is differentiable at a particular point, our work is to prove that it is continuous. So for us to prove it is continuous, what is the condition that is required? So what is the condition we are supposed to prove? Have this in your mind: limit extends to c f of x should be equal to f of c. This is the proof. Now we will start the proof. Consider f of x minus f of c. So if I consider f of x minus f of c, then you can write f of x minus f of c as, so observe this step, multiplying, dividing the numerator with x minus c. So I can write it as f of x minus f of c divided by x minus c into x minus c, right? Now taking the limit on both the sides, limit extends to c f of x minus f of c is equal to limit extends to c f of x minus f of c divided by x minus c into x minus c. We can write it like this, right? Now splitting the limit to each function, we can write it as limit extends to c f of x minus limit extends to c f of c is equal to limit extends to c f of x minus f of c divided by x minus c into limit extends to c x minus c. So when I write it like this, if you observe this one, so limit extends to c f of x is going to be f of c. Okay, I'm not disturbing it, I'm leaving it as it is. Limit, since our work is to prove that limit extends to c f of x, I'm not disturbing it. Limit extends to c f of x minus, this value is going to be f of c only, because you substitute c again, nothing is going to happen. This whole thing is called as f dash of c into, when I substitute extends to c here, c minus c is going to be 0. So from this, what we can conclude is limit extends to c f of x minus f of c is equal to 0. From this, limit extends to c f of x is equal to f of c. So this is a condition for continuity of a function. So what we have done is, we have considered that the function is differentiable, then we proved that the function is continuous. So that is the statement here. So if you say a function is differentiable at a particular point, then it is also continuous at that particular point. Then the corollary here is, every differentiable function is continuous. So this is a very important point. If at all you need to prove that a given function is differentiable at a particular point, the first step you need to understand is, you need to verify whether the given function is continuous or not. If it is not continuous, you need not even proceed to the second step. You can stop it there itself, saying it is not differentiable because it is not continuous.